happy Sunday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Let me give you the latest update on what's going on with these tropical waves. Still showing a potential hurricane could still form up. At least a tropical storm trying to strengthen up to a hurricane. And we have some severe weather to talk about also. And maybe not so severe. I will let you know in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you do subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecasting. I've been talking about this potential tropical storm hurricane forming up about a month ago in the data, and it's been popping up ever since about 2 weeks ago in the model data. Now, matter of fact, 2 weeks ago is exactly what we are seeing this morning for the opportunity of a turn into the Gulf or along the East Coast and just buzzsaw the East Coast, maybe even a fish storm going into Atlantic affecting no one, that we need to watch out for Bermuda. But what I'm showing in my latest information is that this is potentially going to travel further to the west. Now, you can see the latest update for this morning. It's already at 40%. I expect this to grow quickly. I will do afternoon updates every single day like I always do when we get these waves getting close. Make sure you click that bell. Make sure you select all so you get all the updates to help other people as nice as you and families as nice as your families. Hit that like button down below. Hit that share button down below. Share this information to others. Let them see what is going on so they can make the decisions for themselves what they should do. A lot of people need a lot more time than just 5 to 7 days to prepare if something like this was to happen. So this will crucially help them prepare, think about what they're going to do in case this does show more of a threat, and potentially save up money to get supplies as well before those get expensive as this becomes more clear of a storm coming. You can also see on the Pacific side, we have multiple waves forming up, even a strong one just like the GFS has been showing, a strong wave coming. Now we're seeing a trend. This is not sloppy all over the place. I am seeing a trend where this storm potentially can go, and I am agreeing with it. What I see in the trend is that this storm wave is still going to keep going this way towards the Bahamas. It's going to get expanded high pressure because that retracts back. It goes this way. It expands. It goes this way. So what I am seeing now is that this is going to go straight this way over to Bahamas, potentially over Florida, then curve and go in that direction. That is what I'm seeing. Let me show you the latest information why I say this. Now remember, it is summer after all, so we do have hot temperatures. There's nothing rare about this. For today, you are going to get up to the 90s, maybe even reach 100 for portions of Colorado going into Kansas, and you still have it for the southwest, for Nevada, California, Arizona, and northwestern Mexico. Now for tomorrow, this is going to expand, but this is where we get that high pressure that just circles around for a while and brings everything around, especially with your dew points. So with your heat indices for tomorrow, you can see it does pull it up and you get over 100 degree feels like temperature from multiple states for tomorrow, for Monday. Don't panic, just hydrate the day before, hydrate today so you'd be good for tomorrow. This is just summer temperatures, everybody. This is normally what we get. This is all expected. And unfortunately, so is wildfire season. So you can see we still have the fires going on in the Northwest. Matter of fact, you can still see that very unhealthy level of smoke is still growing over here for portions of Oregon as you go through Burns and Hines. So remember, if you're going outside in this area, make sure you wear the particulate mask for smoke. It's very easy to get into your lungs. It's very hard to get out of your lungs. You can also see that it is building up over here for California as well. Now the orange is unhealthy for sensitive groups like asthma and such. The red is unhealthy for everyone, but this purple gets to where it's very unhealthy. Now, latest information according to what Euro is seeing is it's seeing that high pressure retracting back, seizes a little time to slip in and maybe buzzsaw around the east coast of the U.S. Matter of fact, I'm showing new information that this will be favoring going right over Florida, then potentially turning. But to show you all the information according to the Euro, showing a chance for a tropical storm still to form as it intensifies and goes around that high pressure. This is the latest information. This is literally 6 days away from this point right here. This could change every day. Matter of fact, when you look at the latest data, chance for a tropical cyclone probability to strike, you see it raises all the way up towards 50 to 60% chance for a tropical cyclone to strike all the way towards southern Florida, and see how it favors going right into the inner side of that Gulf of Mexico. Then you will see that curve. You can see this all the way to August 5th. Then the next shot, you can see it strengthens up, favoring right here and curving around the East Coast. This is exactly the way I'm seeing this path going. Our sea surface temperatures are very warm as of the latest shot of Friday, showing if it went along the East Coast, it would still stay strong all the way towards the Carolinas, but showing the best waters is still right where it shows it's heading, right towards the Bahamas and the eastern side of the Gulf of Mexico. Very above average warm waters in that area. So when you look at the latest run, you can see with the Euro, when you look at your 500 millibar vorticity, this is the best shot to show anything because you can see the weather pattern. So you see your high pressure retracting back, you see the trough coming in, and you can see that little slip showing that it could move right on in that little area, steering around the coast, getting hit with that front right here of that trough coming in, and that would shear it and push that to the east, northeast, if it was to show true. I'm showing this potentially could form a little bit later, go right across Florida, and potentially buzzsaw the whole East Coast. But showing a Euro literally in 6 days, it will be somewhere over here by the Bahamas. When you look with the Canadian, it brings a little bit more into the Caribbean. When you look with the GFS, it brings a lot weaker, but it agrees with that same location as the Canadian, a little bit further towards the west. Going by the latest information, you can see with the Euro, it brings a little bit further to the north. A weak high pressure allows that to travel north and start strengthening up. And potentially, this is what everyone should vote for right here, because I don't cheer these storms on. We try and practice safety here and keep people as safe as possible. These storms are no joke and they change lives. You should vote for this one right here. This one shows that it will start forming up by Bahamas and go out to the Atlantic Ocean. No threat to anyone, not even the Bahamas, maybe a little bit of rainfall, because this will be east side and north side loaded, so none of the impacts would hit land from this system if this was to still show true. This is the latest run with the Euro. Now you can see with the Canadian, it sees it a little bit further. The high pressure is only expanding. It's still a little strong high pressure, and it pushes it right into that Gulf of Mexico by the time we go through the third, and then curves to the north as we go further along. We get this high pressure revolving around here, and this pushes that further to the west as it goes right over it. Strengthens up to a potential hurricane as it goes right into the Gulf. Now, when you look at the latest run with the Canadian, you can see it shows it in the same region, and it shows it doing the same thing. A little bit closer towards Florida, so that's why I believe this could potentially still curve around. Canadian has shown there'll be a high pressure blocking right there, and that will not allow that to stay super strong and go around that very fast. Showing it is going potentially in the Gulf. And this is where I'm seeing things could go, right in that direction, and then go around. Now, multiple things could happen with this storm system as this tropical wave comes close. As it goes through all these islands, it would keep it weak. As it goes through all these islands and then going to southern Florida, it would keep it weak over landfall, and it wouldn't be able to strengthen up really strong and intensify. That's why it's trying so hard. So landfall interaction would keep this wave weak until the last minute. Remember, the trend has always been rapid intensification and always at the last minute, and that's what we're seeing. If you look with the GFS, you can see it takes it further towards the west, but you can also see that tropical wave tries to come around. It actually splits into two pieces. One does go around like the Euro is seeing. Another one travels to the west. Now, when you go by the latest update, you can see right here on your 500 millibar vorticity that here's your tropical wave, splits into two, showing it could be something weak going around the high pressure like we see with the Euro, and it could be traveling further to the west as well. This is what the GFS has been contemplating on. The Euro seen it one time and it took it away, but look how it brings that right north into the Gulf of Mexico on that second piece. So it is trending that as well. Matter of fact, GFS is agreeing with both of them. It could happen. And the latest run, the 6Z, shows the same thing. That would be something weak, pushing to the west. More than likely will not make it according to the GFS. Now, if you take a look at the run that GFS had yesterday, it saw it curving right around here, right around the 6 or 7 days, but it takes it a little bit longer than the Euro. It takes it slower, but it's showing the same thing, that it could potentially go right into that Gulf and strengthen up. So it could strengthen up right over here along the coast of Florida. It could strengthen up more than likely across Florida, right here in the Gulf, maybe running out of time. And if it goes further to the west, it could be something stronger and go through multiple states with that. because you can also see with the Euro, this is literally in 6 days, showing that you have dry air all around this system. And if you take a good look at it, you'll see that it's starting to get some shear. All the precipitation is pushing east. It is not around the center of the storm, so it is getting sheared. It has dry air around it, so it only has a certain amount of time to try and form up. It gets a little more vertically stacked as it goes away and starts strengthening up as it goes around the coast. This right here wouldn't do no impacts. If it was closer just a little bit, we could potentially have a problem, showing it does keep strengthening as it goes up the coast. Now, when you look with the ensembles, you can see with the Euro, it's a green with the members, more like it will be in this spot as we go into 6 days. But once we go past this, you can see it does favor going a little bit towards the east, but now you're really getting three spots. It can go inner, it can go a little bit further north, or go a little bit further to the west. So it's not really set in stone that that curve will happen, because you can see some is showing these members. Some is also showing it could be a little bit further to the west on these members and go right towards the Carolinas and agreeing maybe a last-minute formation into the Gulf as well. Now, when you look at the other ensembles, when you look at GFS, you can see it is showing that group of storms almost in the same location, but it favors a strengthening high pressure and expanding high pressure and pushes all those further towards the west. You can see this with the Canadian also, showing that group of storms in 6 days and showing more than likely will go further towards the west. So going by the ensembles according to the Euro, and you can see everything showing maybe a small chance for that to form up late into the Gulf of Mexico, but that is actually the trend. And Euro is believing that it more likely will be right along the coast and not so much missing everything. So this could go right along the coast and just skim right along the edge and then come right up this way. That's why I do afternoon updates, so we can see what the latest information and follow the trend of what's going on. And you can see with the Icon, the only model that saw a barrel, showing literally in 5 days, a little bit further to the southern side. Still no formation because it's traveling weak. That's always been the trend. But it's agreeing with the Canadian and the GFS. This will be a further into the northern side of the Caribbean, traveling to the west, rather than over here towards the Bahamas on the northern side of that cone. It's showing the southern side. I will show you this afternoon the latest information. Now, when you look at latest potential velocity anomaly, the same way that we followed this wave over a month ago, showing with the Euro that this will more likely be right along the east coast somewhere, and you will have storms in the Pacific. Now, this is normally what you see when you try and follow tropical waves. So when we saw Beryl do this and actually do this, all this favorable environment, all this lift and convection, a strengthening three times storm, and we had this. Well, we got another one of these coming right into the middle of August. This should be just a weak tropical wave, a tropical depression. I will keep you updated, but showing a lot of unfavorable environment for the rest of August after we deal with this. Now, normally, right after the first week of August, other meteorologists, they'll double down. They'll say, hey, it's about to start ramping up. We're about to pick up. I'm showing that's not true. But remember last time we showed that was not true. We had barrel form out of this thing right here. And showing we have something stronger than what we're dealing with now right in the beginning of September. Now, real quick, go through your severe weather of what you have for today. You do have the chance for tornadoes, a 2%. Colorado State University don't see any chance. But so far, here's your cities and states at risk for the potential tornado threat for today. You do have chances for high winds, even damaging winds of hurricane force, 74 miles per hour at least. That's in this black hatched area. So here's your cities and states at risk for the chance for damaging wind threat for today. And you also have the chance for the hail threat as well. This is coming from that shortwave trough. Here's your cities and states at risk for today. National Weather Service only has scattered, strong, severe thunderstorms are expected across parts of the central and northern plains this afternoon into tonight. And showing the best chance for those winds is going to be around South Dakota and the broader Siouxland vicinity, with the threat of severe gusts potentially exceeding 75 miles per hour today. So to pick up where we left off, you can see where our pattern is. We do have that high pressure right here swinging this big group of moisture to the north. We still got this coastal low over here off the coast. It's not going to do anything still. It's just going to bring in maybe a little bit of rainfall as this comes through for this evening and starts popping up your storms from that shortwave trough. Late night, early in the morning storms. Then for tomorrow, this should just bring a little bit of rainfall. It looks worse than it is. It's big and broad. But for tomorrow, potentially popping your storms up again for that chance for some severe weather to kick in. So for today, you can see as the storms kick in, you get some storms brewing up over here for Tennessee, Kentucky Valley, Ohio Valley. This is not going to be super bad in nature. Just some thunderstorms popping up. But over here for the Dakotas going towards Minnesota, you go get some straight line winds that come out of this storm cell. You can see this right here for northern Minnesota. And you can get a spin up potentially out of the cells that comes from South Dakota. What I'm seeing mostly is it's going to be a damaging wind event coming with that storm cell. Then as you go by early in the morning, then for tomorrow, popping right back up again for northern Illinois, going towards Indiana with these storms. And that coastal low right off the northeast is going to bring some rainfall with that as well. That's about it. But as soon as that comes in, brings some rainfall, when this dips in for tomorrow, brings severe weather, that's going to go towards the northeast and bring some more storms for y'all as well. But I am showing on the lower level winds as you go through later tonight. Remember, this is central time. That your winds aloft on these cells shows it could start strengthening up as it goes from South Dakota into Minnesota and a little bit of Iowa. Then tomorrow it strengthens up again as it goes from Illinois into Indiana. Now this could bring a chance for a supercell, maybe spin up a chance for a tornado. I'm showing that a very low threat. I'm showing this will be mostly damaging winds as this passes through. You can see so far with the 15-minute increments, that as you go through later tonight, once you start around 5 and 6 o'clock, you start getting 50 and 60, maybe even 70 miles per hour wind gusts on these storm cells from Montana, Wyoming, and South Dakota, and that pushes to the east, bringing 50 in orange, 60 in the red, and 70 in the brown. Even some for Kansas and some building up for Iowa as well. So for tomorrow, it says that you also have a chance for a tornado threat, even a bigger 2%. But once again, when I look at Colorado State University, they're not showing anything. So we're seeing that the storms could form somewhere around northern Illinois and going towards Indiana. I'm not showing the whole region. Still, here's your cities and states at risk for a chance for a tornado for tomorrow from National Weather Service. Also, your chances for winds. You have 5% chance, and you have chances for hail in the same regions for tomorrow. Here's your cities and states at risk for that. And as you go into Tuesday, you got a 5% risk, chance for severe weather. This does not mean it's going to bring all kinds of tornadoes. So if someone's telling that, please don't believe that. That is not what I'm seeing in the atmosphere. But so far, here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather threat for Tuesday. I will keep you updated. And you can see for today, have you have a chance for that tornado threat with National Weather Service? Look right here from Colorado State University, showing nothing. As you look for tomorrow, they have that bigger 2%. And once again, I'm seeing strong winds aloft overnight to the early morning hours, chance for damaging winds. And look right here for Colorado State University, they're showing nothing. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope you have a great day today. Be careful of these storms. I will see you this afternoon for the latest tropical update. It is going to be a shorter video. The updates always are. Thank you so much for everyone that helps notify others what is going on. Because now you see we're actually dealing with this tropical wave. And we have more potentially coming later on. So we'll keep you updated. Before you go today, a quick word from our Father, Deuteronomy 31:6. Be strong and of good courage. Fear not, nor be afraid of them. For the Lord thy God, he it is that doeth go with thee. He will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Amen. You know, the one thing that is in the Bible 365 times is the words, fear not. Now, he says it for every day of our year. Do not fear every day. Fear not. For he is in control. It is God's will that controls everything. We only see it play every day. That's it. We don't know what's coming. Only he knows who's coming. So as God telling us every single day, fear not. So fear not of the things you hear. Fear not of the things you see. God is always in control. Matter of fact, there's a big betrayal going on and God will reveal it. I do believe that 2024 is the year of reveal. We've been getting so much going on. Thank you for your time, everybody. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you this afternoon.